Good afternoon, everyone, and welcome to Composer's Weekend at Bellevue Heights Church. This is the hottest ticket in town. I left the church. We have three services, one on Saturday at 5, two on Sunday, 9 and 10:30. I was leaving around 11:45 or 12 o'clock, and I think some of you were coming right then to get your seat right here. Sun, you know, Arizona has their own timing with no daylight savings time. Sun City has their own time. Sun City time is totally different than anywhere else. We have an overflow crowd to people in the fellowship hall. Wave to everybody, say hello. Friends, what you have before you is just going to be an amazing time of worship and praise to our God. We have like 150 voices, a combination of the sounds of the Southwest Singers and the BHC Singers, but we've got 50 more over here that have just joined. So get your music out, sing, not too loud, but sing, okay? We do that. So we have overflow crowds, and friends, my name is Rob. I am the pastor here, and I just wanted to, if you're visiting with us today, we are so glad that you're here. We love Bellevue Heights. If you do not have a Bible teaching church here in Sun City, we would love for you to come visit with us and worship with us. Great things are happening here, and we need you to come, because right now, if you didn't know, I'm going through a 10-week sermon series called Bible versus Culture, Which One Will You Believe? We're in week number 4, and in this, I'm comparing and contrast what culture says against what the Bible says on such topics as evolution, abortion, homosexuality, transgender, feminism, government, and things like that. People ask me, well, how's it going, Pastor Rob? Well, I said, well, the response has been strong, about 90% positive, but 10% have been upset. The only problem is, it's been a different 10% every week, and over 10 weeks, we may not have anybody here. So come give us a try and come worship with us. I say we're the friendliest church in town. We've got a special guest, Lloyd Larson, who has come in from Minneapolis. He's leading our choir. He's been with us all weekend, and he already picked up something about Bellevue Heights. He says, every time you guys meet, you always have food. You always eat. But I hate to say, we're not having food afterwards. But I've called 5 food trucks, and they're going to be outside when we get back. Okay, we're going to see what we do. Friends, we're going to have a good time. I want to open us in prayer. I pray your hearts will be blessed today. Join me now. Dear God in heaven, we rejoice, for the joy of the Lord is our strength, and our joy comes from you. We have just an indescribable happiness and peace as we gather together in your house called the church. But we know the church is not a building. It's a body. It's not an organization. It's an organism of living beings who belong to you and serve you. Today, we want to honor you and glorify you through music. May you receive glory and honor in all that we do. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Ladies and gentlemen, give a round of welcome to the BHC Singers and the Sounds of them. Lloyd.
Well, thank you, folks, for coming. We were thinking, you know, if this wound up being an empty room, it would just be like another rehearsal for these folks who spent a lot of hours in preparation for your arrival today, and I thank you for that. Before we launch into our music this afternoon, I do want to extend a special thanks to the Bellevue Heights Church. Pastor David Toom, who directs the local choir here, called me, trying to sit there incognito, but he called me last August. We began to communicate, and he said, hey, we do this event every year, and we'd like for you to come. And he said, well, I said, now where are you? And he said, Sun City, Arizona. I said, now when do you want me to come? He said, February. I live in Minnesota. That took me about 3 seconds to say, yeah, I think I can do that. Ironically, we've had a very mild winter in Minnesota this year, so it's not quite the disparity of temperatures and snowfall and all that kind of thing that we might have in some winters. But regardless, I thank you for providing some great weather this weekend. But a deep sense of gratitude to David Toombs for coordinating this event, for preparing his choir, and also to my friend Matt Deller, who's sitting right down here, who directs the Sounds of Southwest Singers. I've known Matt, I think we decided, probably going back close to 20 years at this point. The last time we saw each other was actually in Europe. We were sharing a podium and some experiences over there, including a concert at Normandy on July 4th with some of us, and just some powerful moments that he and I have shared in his churches and with his musical groups as well. So to come and to kind of reconnect with him and his group, which represents half or so of the singers in front of you, as well as David's group. And we've got fabulous other participants. Janelle has been a great pianist for us this weekend, and she's kind of helping the cause. Terry is our narrator over here, and you'll hear why she is our narrator today. And Anita, who will be our soloist on one of the hymns later on. I think it's appropriate to give you just a little background information on this particular project. You see in the program that you received some of the information, including the listing of the hymns that will be a part. I remember distinctly 2001 after 9/11. And I remember going back to church, perhaps the first Sunday or the first couple of Sundays after we had experienced that devastating event in the life and the history of our country. And I remember the profound impact that some of the great hymns of the church had upon me as we gathered for worship, reflecting on those moments that we had collectively experienced as a country. O God, our help in ages past, great is thy faithfulness. It is well with my soul, among many others. I am not anti new songs, new hymns, praise and worship genre, whatever you want to call it. All of those are important for all of us in our collective voice of worship and praise to our God. And one of the things I remember and recall readily is that the hymns even listed in your program today, they were all brand new on one day. And probably met with some reticence, even in the communities of faith where they might have been initially premiered. But those hymns, and the hymns we will sing today, have withstood the test of time, I think, because they have something to say. And they still have something to say. The hymns, as we have experienced them and sung them and embraced them over the years, helped us to focus on our faith. They have articulated the truths of our faith. They have helped me on my own personal journey of faith to understand my God and to kind of focus my own understanding of the truths of God's Word. Well, I shared with you about my reactions and my feelings in 2001. But fast forward about a number of years, 20 years or so later, January of 2021, my wife and I were on a road trip, and we were listening. You can't get a CD player in new cars these days, but at that point, we had a car with a CD player, and we were listening to a hymns project that we had done while I was at college. My wife and I were at college at Anderson University in Anderson, Indiana, back in the mid-70s, and we were listening to a hymn project that we had done. Dr. Dale Bankston, who I think might be listening live stream today from his home in Texas, had been the point person on that particular project. And we were listening to this project as we were driving, and I said, man, it's time for somebody to do another hymns project, I think. And so I began texting Dr. Bankston, Dr. B as I call him, and I said, Dr. B, I think it's time for somebody to get on board and maybe make something happen with another hymns project. And he said, Let's talk about that. And so we began to, and he became kind of my own personal consultant on this particular project. His fingerprints are indelibly etched on this entire project. He's one of the giants along my own personal path of life and career, and we all have those. So anyhow, that became kind of the catalyst for the development of this particular project. And as we walk through this, you will see a rather linear progression of thought and theology, because we open with Come Christians Join to Sing, where essentially it serves as an invitation for all of us to come into this place of worship and to sing and to celebrate the music of our faith. Then we move through and acknowledge and recognize the providence and the faithfulness of our loving and living God. We move to the sacrifice and the gift and the presence of Jesus Christ our Lord. And then ultimately we go to the presence of the Holy Spirit, the empowering presence of the Holy Spirit in our lives as we walk lives of faith. And it culminates with the promise of our heavenly dwelling as a result of a life of faith. Now, this afternoon, you see 150 plus singers in front of you who are going to lead a lot of this, but this is an all-skate event. And by that, I mean that I'm going to turn on multiple occasions and invite you to sing. There may be even one or two occasions where I may invite you to stand if you're able to do so and to join us on a verse of hymn here and there. The words will be on a screen in front of you, so you won't have to say, I don't know those words, because they're going to be right there. Now, some of you have never been invited to sing in a choir before. And maybe there's good reason for that. I don't know. But today, you are invited, and I have good news for you. Some of you say, well, I really don't sing. But the psalmist invited you on multiple occasions to make a joyful noise. And so if your music is a joyful noise, that's okay today. We're going to lift the rafters here as we sing together these hymns of faith. And so I pray that God will speak to you and to all of us together as we sing together, as we rejoice together, and as we offer our gifts of praise to a loving God through this festival of hymns.
we gather in an invitation of praise to join our voices in the hymns of our faith, lifting our hearts to God, Creator, Redeemer, and Lord. This is the place and the time to give the gifts of heart to our God, the Lord Almighty. In word and in song, we offer our praise to the Almighty. The hymns of Scripture urge us to sing to the Lord a new song and to make known God's salvation from day to day. We live in an assurance that our God will be with us, never to leave us nor forsake us. God's compassions never fail. They are renewed every morning. Great is thy faithfulness.
Thank you.
God sent a Messiah to his waiting and hoping people. This expected one fulfilled a promise of life and life eternal. We celebrate the one who came and who changed the world. In loving worship, we lift up the name above all names, Jesus, worthy of our endless praise. Greater love than this, than one should give a life for another. How can it be that this unmerited love has become a gift for us, a salvation in which we all share. By faith, we receive this gift of life and life eternal. The cross, that unmistakable symbol of our faith, has turned a Roman tool for death into a sign of life. The cross is a powerful symbol that reaches upward to God and stretches arms out to all the world. Such sacrifice demands nothing less than my soul, my life, my all. In all the seasons of life, we will know times of joy and sorrow, It is the assurance of God and the fellowship of the community of faith that settles our fears and gives us strength for our journey. Because of all we hold in our hearts and through the gospel of Jesus Christ, the unshakable theme for our life in all times can always be, it is well with my soul.
Oh,
Fanny Crosby, the prolific lyricist of over 8,000 hymn texts, gave to us moving words of faith and did so beyond the challenge of her own life as a person coping with blindness. Yet, she filled the world with the light of such powerful words and traveled the world far beyond any limits of her own time. We know and share in some of her best known words, "Blessed assurance, Jesus is mine," and "To God be the glory, great things he hath done." Jesus concluded just 3 short years of earthly ministry, preaching, teaching and healing, with the promise that he would not leave us alone. He sent a comforter, a source of wisdom and guidance, the Holy Spirit. Such a gift enables us to do far more than could be accomplished in the limitations of time and space. The Holy Spirit, third person in the Trinity, is a living presence of God to extend the powers of love to a vast and needy world. This present God resides in the hearts of believers, and we are blessed by this power to live in the service of God's calling and in the many acts of redeeming love. The hymns of our faith have become a true festival of hope and love. The Apostle Paul calls us to live by grace, this amazing and undeserved gift of God ever with us. And in this assurance, we live and serve as we join with the everlasting cloud of witnesses who surround us, joining in everlasting songs of praise. Amazing grace, how sweet the sound. Heaven's songs, sing them again and again.
Save our wretched feet. You may sit down for a minute. Oh, my goodness. I have to say that there were times I envied you because I could hardly sing. Wasn't it hard to sing some of this? So absolutely elegant and beautiful. And Lloyd, all we can say is thank you. I was thinking, and this is for Pastor Rob and Pastor Tim back in the back. In the book of Revelations, it doesn't talk about great preaching in heaven, but it does talk about great singing. And I think we had a wonderful preview of that today. What do you think? It was amazing. Amazing. Thank you. Thank you. The folks behind me have labored and labored and labored, and I think arousing a gift ovation to them is appropriate. Just to them. Sounds of the Southwest Singers, BAC Singers, thank you. Also, Matt, would you stand, please? Because this young man has directed Sounds of, he's the founder of Sounds of the Southwest Singers, he and his wife, and keeps doing how many years now? 14 years. And and this is not all of them. There's another 100 or something, I don't know. Anyway, thank you so much, Matt. Thank you so much. Well, what a glorious afternoon it has been. And you know, Lloyd reminded us this weekend that all the preparation that goes on, the beautiful music that's written, almost, unless you come and hear it, it becomes very self-centered in some ways. We enjoy it, but to be able to share it and live into your lives with it makes all the difference in the world. So thank you. Would you thank our great audience tonight? Thank you for that. One other thought, and then we're going to go. And that is that I was thinking about Lloyd and all those like you, Lloyd, who labor and labor and labor to do these wonderful, provide us such wonderful music. And I don't think you got into it for the money. And yet I think about the thousands and thousands and millions of people, you know, that are affected and enriched by what you do, and we give you thanks. Please keep it up. He had a birthday this year. He'll tell you how old he is. I won't. So, well, Lloyd, if you would do this, if you would go to the foyer so that people can greet you and enjoy meeting you, and as he does that, let's bow our heads in prayer, shall we? Gracious and loving Father, this has been your gift to us today. A gift of love, a gift of grace, the gift of music when it all comes together in song. Father, we love you and we thank you for Jesus our Lord. We thank you this afternoon for your servant Lloyd, who's taken hymns written across the centuries and just gave them a little changed, significant changes. But small to bring beauty and joy to our hearts and lives. So, Father, thank you for your love. Thank you for your grace. Thank you for this amazing afternoon we've had in celebrating Jesus our Lord. And now, Father, as we go, please keep everyone safe. Please keep everyone well. And most of all, Father, keep everyone close to you. We love you. In Jesus' name, and all God's children said, amen. Amen. Thank you so much for coming and have a wonderful evening. Could I have your attention just a minute, please? Just a minute. Just a minute. I need one more thing. My wife said I should write everything down, and I don't. Terry Summers. Janelle West. And our great AV tech team in back. Thank you. All right. Now you can get noisy.